the earth. Everything was made by the word of God, and nothing, whether visible or invisible, was created without him. I can still recall the sound of the morning stars singing together, and all of the angels shouting for joy at the work of God's hands. I am Michael, the Archangel. On the day I was created, God ordained me with what seemed like the highest honor of any angelic being, except for one. Lucifer was the anointed cherub and the seal of God's perfection. No created being was as perfect in beauty, nor as full of wisdom. Instruments of praise were prepared for him on the day he was created, and he led the angelic host in worship before God's throne. So many times I stood at his side as we sang praises to our Lord and Creator. Fellowship with him in response to his sovereign love. All of creation was in perfect harmony, praising God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the universe was full of his glory.
have forsaken who you are. How dare you tempt my wrath to cast a fallen star? Have I not established you in sovereignty and love? Was that not enough? Why was that not enough? You have chosen in this moment how you'll spend eternity. You have sealed your fate with this iniquity. Out forever, I'll destroy your perfect name. I will see that Lucifer shall never be the same.
One more.
How could Lucifer defy God with such sinful pride when he had walked blamelessly in the midst of God's holy presence from the day he was created? Nevertheless, he had severed his relationship with God forever. Lucifer led a rebellion against the angelic host, and his influence was so powerful that he persuaded one-third of the angels to forsake their habitation in heaven to follow him. God changed Lucifer's name to Satan, and the fallen angels were changed into demons. Then God prepared a place of everlasting fire for them and sentenced them to eternal banishment. Satan contended with God that he was unloving and unjust, but God had a plan to show all of creation that he is just and his love is perfect. Now the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God hovered over the face of the waters. Then God spoke the words and commanded light to shine in the darkness. He brought forth life out of the void, and he restored order out of the chaos. God created every living thing with which the waters abounded, and every bird that flew across the face of the sky. He created every beast of the field, and every living thing that moved on the earth. Then, in his very own image, God created man and gave him dominion over all the earth. God named him Adam, and he brought every beast and bird to him. And whatever Adam called each creature became its name.
They look so in love.
and it feels like something's missing in me. But hey, this is Eden, and it's a wonderful place. Yeah, this is paradise. Sun's always on my face. You can find about anything.
Yeah.
You can hear creation sing.
Yeah.
There's so much here to see. Living in this garden with me. I've got the strangest pet, the cutest animal I've ever met. When I saw his adorable nose, I said, hey, I've gotta have one of those. I love a pig, yes I do. My favorite animal in this zoo. Not really a cat, not really a dog, so I called him my hog. There are times when I walk through the forest at dawn, watching the doe with their fawn. Each time I see a new family, it feels like something's missing in me. Is Eden, and it's a wonderful place.
Yeah, this is paradise.
Sun's always on my face. You can find about anything.
Yeah,
you can hear creation sing.
Yeah,
there's so much here to see. Living in this garden with me, I thought I'd seen it all. Till I heard this caterwaul. When I turned, it was big and fat. And I said, hey, what the heck is that? It had the longest snout, the biggest ears without a doubt. He's amazing to see, he's sure not a runt. Hey, I found an elephant. By the seashore at night, the fireflies are giving their light. I try to ignore, but my heart longs for more. Is there something missing in me?
Living here in Eden,
it's a wonderful place.
Yeah, this is paradise.
Sun's always on my face. You can find about anything here.
Yeah.
You can hear creation sing.
Yeah.
There's so much here to see. Living in this garden with me.
What a lovely garden to see.
Living in this garden with me. It's such a lovely garden to see.
Yeah.
Adam gave names to every bird and beast, but he couldn't find a soulmate comparable to himself. God saw that it wasn't good for him to be alone. So, he caused a great sleep to fall upon him. And as he slept, God took one of his ribs and made it into a woman. And when Adam had risen from his sleep, God brought her to him.
She must have taught the stars to shine. They glisten in her eyes. I never thought this heart of mine would be taken by surprise. Did I love till now?
Did I see till now?
Such beauty,
such wonder, captured in one face. Did I sing till now? Can this be somehow?
Brightest day and make it seem as night. Heaven must have found a way to share this gracious light. What are all these feelings striving for control? This is all so new to me, this joy that floods my soul.
See till now
such beauty,
one face.
Wanted to take by force had been graciously given to them, and his anger deepened. Satan was jealous that God loved mankind so much, but he realized that he could use that love against him. He knew that Adam and Eve had been given the freedom of choice, and that God had commanded Adam not to eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So, in order to tempt Adam to disobey, he planned to deceive the heart of Eve.
So many fruits, so many trees, so many choices for you. As you please, what's this one here, especially sweet? Has God indeed said that you shall not eat?
That is the fruit we must not try.
Good, hiding.
How could you know? How could you see? Unless you have eaten the fruit of this tree.
Placed a curse upon all of the earth. They lost their spiritual lives. Their bodies were destined to die. And yet, while they lived, they had become slaves to sin and had given Satan the authority to rule the world. Satan thought the battle was over. He thought he had put God in an impossible situation, for he knew if God overlooked the sin of mankind, he would prove himself unjust. And if he did not pardon their sin, he would prove himself unloving. God knew that the sin of mankind could only be cleansed by the shedding of blood. And to obtain eternal redemption, he alone would have to pay their debt with his own blood. He also knew that he must become a man and offer himself as a sacrifice.
Paradise was theirs until this day, but now the world is crying out in pain, suffering beneath this sinful stain. How it grieves my heart to see their lives destroyed as I stare into this void. Father, stand me in this gap. Let your grace and mercy flow. I will be their sacrifice. I don't want to let them go. I will pay at any cost just to save those who are lost. Father, stand me in this gap.
Father,
would die for their peace. I will pay at any cost just to save Father, stand me in this
God's love for mankind was so great that he was willing to give his only begotten Son as a sacrifice to pay for their sins, so that whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. God had promised Satan that the seed of the woman would eventually conquer him. And for many generations, I witnessed that seed of promise continuing through God's chosen people of Israel. Satan and his demons were constantly trying to attack God's people and destroy his plan. And there were countless events when we were sent to help and protect God's people. But finally, after thousands of years, the time had come for the seed of promise born.
Thank you.
Joseph and Mary went up into the city of Bethlehem to be registered. And while they were there, the days were completed for Mary to deliver her firstborn son. There was no room for them in the inn that night, so she wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him.
Darkest night, anytime you
cry out, your summon will be heard. Anytime you need me, I'll be here. I am your angel. Just say the word.
As Jesus grew, he became strong in spirit and filled with wisdom. By the time he was 12, he was already in the temple answering questions, and all who heard him were astonished at his understanding. Throughout his early life, Jesus remained subject to his parents and was raised as a carpenter's son, all the while increasing in wisdom and stature, and in favor with God and man. When Jesus reached the age of 30, he began to preach, calling for the people to repent. I listened as he taught the people how to live, how to love, and how to pray through his parables and sermons. And I witnessed as he performed countless miracles. A great multitude followed him as his fame spread, but when he returned to his own country, they did not honor him, and I marveled at their unbelief and their blindness to the blessing that stood before them.
I walk so many nights, searching your hearts and praying you return. How I long to gather you here in my arms tonight and lives with heaven's joy and all of heaven's light. Jerusalem, my chosen people, how can you deny? despise me now, Jerusalem? Won't you see somehow? Why must you destroy my prophets, killing those I sent to you, Jerusalem? What more must I do? I long to gather you here in my arms tonight and fill your lives with heaven's joy and all of heaven's light.
Casting your word aside. How they fill their hearts with deception, how they fill their hearts with envy. Is this the way you want your kingdom to be? Don't you know that you see?
Yet for you to choose.
a man. I will mar your earthly visage more than anyone can tell. I will strike you as you're crying out in pain within the flames of hell.
Turn to blood.
not my will, but yours be done.
They took him and beat him beyond recognition. They mocked him and put a crown of thorns upon his head and led him away to be crucified. Any word, just one word, and I could have destroyed them all and swept him away from that cruel torture. But he never said a word, and he was led as a lamb to the slaughter. All of the angels were astonished. We were rendered silent, paralyzed by terror as we witnessed our Lord being crucified. I heard him cry out in the darkness, asking his father why he had forsaken him. And for a moment, I couldn't understand how God the Father could turn his back on his son. But suddenly, I understood. And I stood there for what seemed like years in awe at the love of God. He loved mankind so deeply that while they were yet sinners, he shed his own blood for the price of forgiveness for their sins. He loved me and all of the angels so deeply that he had ultimately displayed his love and justice to us. He loved the Father so deeply that he humbled himself and was obedient unto death, even the death of a cross.
When will His majesty fill this place?
When will His glory shine upon my face?
When will my soul breathe relief within?
When will He live again?
When will He
How can my heart sing without its song?
How can this night last so long?
It seems the darkness will never end.
When will He live again?
When will He
days can feel like a thousand years.
When will the morning appear?
When will my soul breathe relief within?
When will He live again?
When will He live? Thank you.
again.
Jesus appeared to his disciples and commissioned them to go into all of the world and preach the gospel to everyone, teaching them to observe all the things he had commanded. He promised them he would always be with them. And then I met him with a host of angels, and we ushered him back into heaven to be seated at the right hand of the Father. Many years have passed since that glorious day. Jesus is highly exalted and has been given a name which is above every name. Satan is still at war with God, but this accuser of the saints of God will not prevail. He may walk the earth like a roaring lion, but he knows the time is short before he is finally cast into the lake of fire. But as for the saints of God, you have a beautiful inheritance that Jesus has prepared for you that is incorruptible and will never fade away. Soon he will return. The Lord himself will descend from heaven, and I will accompany him with a mighty shout as Gabriel sounds his horn. There will be no more death, nor sorrow. There will be no more hunger, nor thirst. There will be no more pain, nor curse. There will be no more night, for the Lord God will be your light. God himself will wipe away every tear from your eyes, and you will reign with him forever.